Hey everyone, it's BDC. Thanks for checking out this video on the channel. I'm doing a build preview video today of a small core BA that I built, a utility base called the O2 Power Production Node. And it basically plays on the same idea that I have from all these other smaller utility type bases, meant to be part of the early survival experience. More or less on a PvE environment, but you can do it on another one if you, or PvP if you so choose. This is another open air type design, and the idea behind this is the combining of two larger production facilities that I have built called the Power Production Node BA and the, I think it's the Oxygen Production Farm. Yeah, that's one of them right there. So this is a smaller version of both of those combined together. And the idea here is to be able to offset and move any kind of power production type stuff and storage early on, early survival game, with anything with promethium pellets, making promethium fuel packs, creation of your first amounts of O2 bottles, water canisters, that kind of thing like that. So one of the things that's particular about this base is that this one has a pool room, just like the O2 production farm BA that's down the down the beach over there. And so this thing is built to have terrain and some water inside of its concrete structure, so it has to be placed down in a particular way along a beach line. It's got markings and all that. I'll show that here shortly, but basically you can come in here and you can have one place to put multiple portable constructors, your little water O2 condensers for meeting O2 bottles, and then water generators. It's more secure than just having them laying around in an unorganized fashion. Just about every time I've ever played on a survival public server, I wind up having several of these things laying around, you know, and then you take either a hike or a small HV or something, and you run off to the beach and you have your four or five water generators sitting out there. So what I decided to do here was to try and collate all that stuff together to put all that in one easy place. It also comes with a 4x4 HV parking area, so you can bring a harvesting HV. I have one of my monkey tools, hover monkeys, out here as an example. You can bring it in, or some other general purpose HV that you've got, where you've gone and either dug up some promethium deposits, or you've gone and gotten a bunch of wood logs or whatever. If you want to do biofuel production, you bring it in here, and then you can toss stuff into the cargo. You can use logistics via the wireless connection block to move stuff around, get power, or excuse me, promethium in raw ore form into the portable constructors and have those things tear it down. Maybe get some of those made smaller promethium fuel packs into the condensers, and then start with your water container generation and production in your water generators. So it's pretty simple. You can also use this for earlier survival oxygen storage. So there's several tanks in here. Total capacity of 10,000, which is decently high for something like this in an O2 station. 16,000 volume. So with one cargo box, you'd be able to store quite a bit of stuff in here before you had the materials available to build real production bases or a real large base where you then move everything back into one spot somewhere. So this is meant to be an interim step, something that's cheap and easy to build. There's also a 2x2x2 spot right here for a large or advanced constructor. If you continue to use this later on to make large promethium packs or even fusion cells. And the solar array that's been set up, it looks like it's 10 small is what I landed on. The solar array is massive overkill for this thing as it stands, since all production, or the vast majority of it, is done off of the portable constructors. There's no real power footprint on here. I mean, it's let me check real quick, but I want to say it's almost next to nothing in terms of consumption. Yeah, 74 kilowatts. It's nothing. So the solar output, I think, will get a little bit over 500, if I recall correctly, on a clear day. And battery setup, I've got three capacitors in here. So if you do decide to put a large constructor in here, you can turn that thing on and run it for a little while to crunch some stuff, to make stuff that the portable constructors can't make, large promethium packs or even fusion cells, if you keep this all the way up to level 20. So, anywho, that's it. It's pretty simple. One thing I do want to show real quick is the way it's built. There's a concrete sarcophagus, as I like to call it, that has a core block and all the other bare essentials. A couple of concrete, like, pylons that dig into the ground for structural integrity type thing. And then I have marked the burial lines here for how it needs to be buried into the terrain. And then this vertical line right here indicates beach line. So the idea is to try and get a mix of terrain and water into the pool room here, obviously, so we can lay our devices down. It is a block tall, actually, technically two. You've got the staircase here and an elevator block right there for accessibility into it. So if it's not perfect, if it's a little bit too high or a little bit too low, it'll still work. That's basically it. So nothing else to it. Motion sensor that kicks on lights at night and that kind of thing. Very low cost, low power footprint to it, and it's a small size. Level 5 unlock, build time's just under 25 minutes in the Blueprint Factory. Requires a little over 1,000 stone dust, 74 iron, 84 copper, 111 silicone, 14 carbon substrate. So it can be built fairly early on, especially if you've got a couple of people that are doing resource allocation and stuff. So again, this is the O2 power production node, that's it. That's basically it. Hope you guys enjoyed it. If you have any comments or questions, please feel free to leave them down below in the description, and smash those like and subscribe buttons. Appreciate you watching the video. Thank you.